So, firstly, there is no armour, because by this period, people did not usually wear armour in the street. Before that, they absolutely did. And a very famous example cited by Ewan Oakeshott of the silversmith Cellini. He was basically pestered and insulted and had rocks thrown at him by this person. And he had brushed it off and went to the pub. And this guy got a couple of his friends and was having at him in the pub, pulled a dagger and attacked him, and Cellini killed him. And the record happens to state that Cellini was wearing a hauberk, chainmail armour, at the time. And it doesn't mention it as something special, it was just describing his clothing. So, in the late 15th century, wearing chainmail armour at the pub was considered fine. Now, but I have two students who have been walking through Ralphian Torre late on a Saturday night, or when I was in a part of Torre. No, I like to read my second favorite city, I'm sure. You're walking, in both cases, they happened to be wearing chainmail because they were coming back from an event, and the easiest way to carry chainmail is to wear it. Okay? And they were wearing chainmail under their ordinary clothes. And in both cases, they were stabbed in an unprovoked way in the back with a knife, which went clink. Okay. But the thing was, you know, wearing chainmail even these days can actually. But in the context in which we're talking about, and what I'm about to show you comes from a treatise written in 1610, and so it's obvious. Actually, in the book, the fences are naked. And I have a t-shirt which says Chapter Pharaoh on one side, fence naked on the back. Now, I don't recommend it, and we don't do it. Sorry, those of you who are looking forward to naked men. Right? The point of them being naked is so you can see how the muscles are working in a given position, and so you can be very precise about the position. Because this is a game of precise positioning. Right? You take this guard position. I read this from the treatise, and I didn't really understand it until I went to the Wallace Collection in London, which has a huge collection of arms and arms. And I got a friend of mine to hold an original from about 1600. Chart had probably been used. And I had an original. And I was a friend of mine.